Hello. This video I'm going to solve a problem on viscometers. Before that, today is a very sad day for me. I came to know that Professor Y.C. Fung has passed away. In fact, I came to know about it pretty late, which is today. He has passed away on December 15th. Professor Fung, who has written numerous books on biomechanics, is one of my mentor, and he is actually the person who got me interested in biomechanics and as well as in biomedical engineering. Professor Y.C. Fung is known as the father of modern biomechanics, and for those of you who don't know about him, I suggest you take a look. So let me move on to the viscometer problem. Whole blood viscosity mu. Whole blood viscosity with known mu. Okay. Is placed in a concentric cylindrical viscometer. The gap width is 1 mm. Okay, so this is a fixed cylinder. This is an outer cylinder that moves. Okay, and the gap between these two cylinders is 1 mm, and the radius of this inner cylinder is 30 mm. The angular velocity of the outer cylinder is 60 revolutions per minute, and with that, the question is, what is the outer wall shear stress in this fluid? This is a very simple problem. Shear stress is defined by viscosity times rate of shear strain. The only trick here is to recognize that the rate of shear strain is also the velocity gradient. Okay. So what is the velocity gradient here? Its velocity is zero here. There is a finite velocity because it rotates. Okay. This should be r times omega at the outer boundary. So there is a gradient of velocity as you move from here to here. Velocity gradient increases. Okay. And this gradient is essentially velocity at the outer wall divided by the distance over which it changes, h. Okay. That's all there is to this problem. And now just need to substitute for all the values and find what the shear stress is. Okay. So mu has, you know, 0.035 given. Newtons per meter square, Newton second per meter square. That times velocity is, so this is mu times r omega over h. Okay. So the radius of the outer wall is 30 plus 1, 31 mm. So 31, I'm going to write all the powers of 10 at the beginning. So 10 power 0, which is 1, we start with that, minus 3 for mm. That times the omega. So omega is 60 revolutions per minute, right? The 60 is 60 revolutions per minute. So number of radians per minute is into 2 pi. We want things in terms of seconds. So a minute has 60 seconds. So that over 60. And finally, the thickness over which things change is 1 mm. So 1, and again, we'll have a factor of 10 here. Okay? So these two factors will cancel out, and what we are left with is 0.68 newtons per meter square. Okay, so this is a very, very simple problem. All we had to do is to use a definition of the shear stress, okay, and we had to recognize rate of shear strain is nothing but velocity gradient. For the given problem, velocity gradient is b over h, okay, and b can be written using rotational velocity or omega. So this is a very simple problem. That's all I wanted to discuss with this video. And if you do not know about Professor Y.C. Fung, I suggest you Google about him and hopefully get inspired the way I got inspired. With that, good luck with your preparations, and I'll see you with another video.